Leopard 2 MBT cross-section. Germany earned a reputation for impressive tank designs, something that continued well after the Second World War. During the Cold War, with fears of Soviet tanks causing more than a few sleepless nights, German engineers developed the Leopard 2, a main battle tank that not only could stand toe-to-toe with Soviet armor, but is still used today as the backbone of many armored forces around the world. Development. Development of the Leopard 2 began in the mid-1960s. Germany had equipped its forces with the Leopard main battle tank. Though a solid tank, it barely entered service when intelligence reports indicated that the Soviets were in development of a tank that would utilize a powerful 125mm main gun, the T-64. Almost instantly, development began on something that could challenge the new Soviet design. The initial plan was a joint project between West Germany and the United States, which led to 14 prototypes of the MBT-70. In spite of this, disagreements about specifications, along with cost overruns, led to the project being canceled. The Americans would then go on to design what would become the M1 Abrams. West German manufacturer Krauss-Maffei began development on the new tank independently, and over a long series of experiments, the first prototypes of what would become the Leopard 2 were ready for testing in 1972. After a few more years of testing, the Leopard 2 was officially approved by the West German government in 1977 and entered service in 1979. Variants. The Leopard 2 has seen continuous service in the German and other militaries for almost half a century, and over that time, there have been numerous variants, each one with modifications that incorporated the latest technological innovations. The base model is designated the Leopard 2 A0, and the majority of sub-variants labeled the A1 through A7, each one seeing changes to the weaponry, communications gear, optics, computer systems, or any number of other modifications. There's also a PSO version, which stands for Peace Support Operations, which was modified for urban warfare, such as having a shorter barrel, non-lethal weapons, and more all-around protection. There were also experiments to equip the Leopard with a larger 140mm main gun, which was designated the Leopard 2 140. There are also variants for training and vehicle recovery. The Leopard 2 is used by many other nations who have modified the tank for their own doctrines and purposes, such as the Finnish Leopard 2R, which is used for clearing minefields, and the Pioneer Panzer III Kodiak, a turretless engineering vehicle used by Switzerland. An A8 version of the Leopard 2 was shown to the public for the first time in May 2023 and will be the latest version of this long-serving vehicle. Dimensions. The Leopard 2 A6 has a length of 32 feet, including the main gun, a width of just over 12 feet, and is around 8 feet high. It weighs in at 68 tons, though it's important to note that this is the 2A6 version, and the exact size can vary greatly depending on the specific variant. For those passionate about tanks and eager to experience them firsthand, War Thunder, the most comprehensive vehicle combat game ever made, offers an unparalleled opportunity. Developed with the powerful Dagor engine, War Thunder lets you command over 2,500 meticulously crafted planes, tanks, helicopters, and ships from 10 major nations. From the humble biplanes and armored cars of the 1920s to today's advanced fighter jets and main battle tanks, War Thunder covers it all. Engage in intense combat scenarios with incredibly detailed vehicles, realistic graphics, and authentic sound effects that place you right in the thick of the action. And with this attention to detail highlighted by their impressive X-ray feature, War Thunder guarantees that every battle feels as real as it gets. War Thunder caters to every type of player with three distinct game modes. For those who crave fast-paced action, Arcade mode offers enhanced vehicle performance and simplified physics. Simulator mode provides the ultimate challenge with no guardrails, while Realistic mode, our personal favorite, strikes the perfect balance between intensity and authenticity. No matter your preference, there is a mode for you. Join a global community of over 70 million players across PC, PlayStation, Xbox, iOS, and Android, and participate in epic PvP battles that'll test your skills and strategy. New and returning players that haven't played in 6 months will also receive a massive bonus pack across all platforms that includes multiple premium vehicles, the exclusive vehicle Decorator Eagle of Valor, 100,000 Silver Lions, and 7 days of premium account. It's available for a limited time only, so be quick. Dive into the action by clicking the links in the description below and discover why War Thunder is unmatched in its genre. Armament. The initial design of the Leopard 2 revolved around the use of a powerful 120mm main gun, which was designed to tear through whatever the Soviet Union could throw at it. Earlier versions used a stabilized Rheinmetall L-44 cannon, with later versions using the longer L-55, which gave the projectile a higher muzzle velocity. The standard ammunition capacity is 42 rounds, stored in the turret with additional shells in the hull. The Leopard 2 also has two MG3 7.62mm machine guns, updated versions of the MG42 machine gun. One is coaxial to the main gun, while the other is mounted on top of the turret. The A7 version has an internal weapons control system that allows the turret-mounted machine gun to be fired from inside the tank. Protection. The armor of the Leopard 2 has evolved greatly over the years. The tank makes use of spaced armor, which means that there are two layers of protection. When a projectile hits the outer plate, it will either detonate or tumble, reducing the kinetic energy of the impact before it hits the main layer of protection. More recent variants use composites of steel, tungsten, and ceramic. The exact makeup and thickness of the armor is speculated, though is classified and difficult to confirm. The A5 variant began the use of an arrowhead-designed turret with sloped armor, giving the Leopard its sleek appearance. The A5 and A6 also feature thicker armor on the turret and the side skirt, which gives additional protection against RPGs. Given experiences during peacekeeping operations, later versions also have additional protection against mines and IEDs. The Leopard 2 is also protected against NBC, or nuclear, biological, and chemical threats, utilizing an overpressurization system that seals off and filters air into the vehicle. 2023 photographs taken from the conflict in Ukraine showed the Leopard, specifically an A4, equipped with explosive reactive armor, though this seems to be a later addition and not standard practice. The Leopard also has a built-in fire suppression system, which will activate automatically should the internal temperature of the tank reach over 180 degrees Fahrenheit, though it can be triggered manually. Crew. The Leopard 2 is operated by a crew of four: a driver, commander, loader, and gunner. The driver is located on the front right of the lower hull. The rest of the crew is located in the turret, the gunner located at the front right of the turret, the commander behind him, and the loader is positioned at the left side of the turret. Engine, performance, and other capabilities. The most recent versions of the Leopard, the 2A4, 2A5, and 2A6, are propelled by an MTU MB873-KA501 series 12-cylinder turbocharged diesel engine, which is capable of generating up to 1,479 horsepower. This power plant can move the tank at around 45 miles an hour on the road, making the Leopard 2 one of the fastest main battle tanks in the world. The 317-gallon fuel capacity, located in four tanks, has a range of about 340 miles. The transmission is automatic, with four forward gears and two reverse gears. The Leopard 2 uses a torsion bar spring suspension system with hydraulic dampeners, and has seven rubber-coated road wheels and four return rollers per side. As one of the most advanced tanks still in the world, with nearly half a century of service, there are many other features that the Leopard uses to operate at maximum potential. These can include laser range finders, night vision capabilities, and advanced communication gear. Users. In addition to Germany, many nations use the Leopard 2 as their primary tank. These nations include, but are not limited to, Austria, Greece, Portugal, Spain, Canada, Norway, Poland, and many others. Many were also sent to Ukraine as part of aid packages to that nation in the face of the Russian invasion. The Leopard 2 in action. The Leopard 2 first saw action during peacekeeping operations in Kosovo in 1998. Since then, it's been used in multiple conflicts, including peacekeeping in Bosnia-Herzegovina, Iraq, Afghanistan, and Ukraine. In Afghanistan, a Canadian-operated Leopard was struck by an IED and survived with no casualties. Canadian Leopards also survived Taliban ambushes on several occasions, surviving them all. During Operation Red Dagger in 2008, Danish Leopards held the flank of the British-led advance in the Helmand province, and were critical for the success of the operation. There are some combat operations that tarnish the otherwise glowing reputation of the Leopard. During the Battle of Al Bab in Iraq, a reported 10 Turkish Leopards 2A4s were destroyed, and two were captured by ISIS. The insurgents made use of IEDs and anti-tank missiles, targeting the turret, which set off the ammunition supply. These were earlier models which didn't have the anti-IED protection of the latter types. The Turkish troops also operated without infantry support, which made them even more vulnerable. In the conflict in Ukraine, Leopards were sent as part of aid packages and were the primary component of a major 2023 Ukrainian counteroffensive. Due to the nature of the conflict, accurate information is difficult to come by, but it is confirmed that at least 11 Leopards were destroyed by Russian forces, many lost to unmanned drones, a new factor on an ever-evolving battlefield. With the nature of warfare constantly changing, the future of the Leopard 2 is unclear. Germany, along with France, are in development of a successor vehicle to replace the decades-old design. Still, it will take many years for this new vehicle to roll off the assembly line. And until that day, the Leopard 2 will still be the backbone of armored forces around the world. A huge thanks to War Thunder for sponsoring today's video. Dive into the action and play War Thunder for free on PC, PlayStation, Xbox, iOS, and Android by clicking on the links in the description below. If you're new or haven't played in the last 6 months, you're in for a treat with a massive bonus pack that includes premium vehicles and other awesome stuff, available on all platforms. Hurry up though, this special offer won't last forever.